Growing up, all I loved was to play football, just like all the other kids here. My dream was to become a footballer, but my mother always said to me, Enoch, follow your passion, but you must work hard. I'm one of the youngest here, and I know I can speak for 100, if not thousands of kids just like me. We play on that pitch, we work hard to get to school, but often trouble gets into the way. There are so many talented kids out there, but we have little hope. There is no path for us to move forward and reach our potential. I've never been to a football justify before, but I've heard of it. But this justify was not what I was expecting. It was different and special. I went and played, but then I had to sit an academic test. The scouts were also looking up to my school report and speaking to my family about taking education serious. The kids in Takoradi know of Tullow. They have seen the sign and know it's a big company there. But suddenly, we saw Right to Dream and Tullow giving us the chance and the path that was never open to us before. Like almost all the kids here, the day I met Jeremy, the day my eyes started to open.
It's amazing the things you find in places you'd never think to look. There are a lot of people who see West Africa as chaotic and undeserving. From a distance, it's very easy to see why one would think that. And then you hear the voices. Coming from hundreds of people huddled around a dirt pitch, captivated by this 10-year-old little boy playing for his life under the absolute worst conditions you could ever imagine. Where else in the world does that happen with a 10-year-old displaying that kind of raw talent? Desire, drive, hunger. This is the environment that has created that 10-year-old boy. It's all about searching for the right talent. There's loads of talent out there. But the right talent is hard to find because the right talent goes beyond the pitch.
What position would you play? You a player yourself?
I played in Europe, Germany, Offenham.
This afternoon we have a trial, you should come.
The right talent takes you to the motorbike driver, who takes you to the heart of the community, and he's grown up there, and he himself was a good footballer, and he did his knee in at 14 and couldn't get into the academy. And he knows inside information about the best footballer in the community. And when he looks into your eyes, he sees possibility and knows you're the hope of the community. Football organizations don't think enough of what social impact they're having on the community. And if the scout does not see that and does not feel that, then he doesn't do justice to the community he's working in. You can't ask a kid to throw themselves into an academy setting when you yourself as a scout hasn't thrown yourself into the community and understood him. You being extremely short-sighted by not appreciating that kid's struggle. Communities in Africa seem to be changing at such a slow rate that if we don't care as scouts, who would care?
Hello, is this Nana's house?
Yes.
Is his mother here?
It's vitally important for us to educate the parent and get them to understand that this is a long-term process.
What school is here?
Salas.
If you prefer to speak in Twi, Prince can do some translations for us. We have a trial next week. You send the letter to the school. so the school are aware and that he doesn't get into trouble with them?
And I say, my name is Unimbo and Opebo. Obeti players beat is Majid Waris, David Akam, Yaoyeboa. Omunyi na omufi ya academy on.
Community relations is hugely important, and schools are a big part of the community.
Good morning, sir. Sorry to disturb you.
You're welcome.
I'm Jeremy from Right to Dream Football Academy. Tu parles anglais?
No.
Tu parles français? Charles Kumado played in our trial this weekend. He's a student with you?
Yes, a student here.
Okay.
There's various ingredients that go into making a player, and getting insight from the school is vitally important.
This is his attendance.
Expliquez, describe pour moi, lui, c'est Marc, les attendances comme ça.
Moi, je comprends pas.
Mathematics, where would you place him?
Place him on top, 5%.
In terms of academic.
Academics, 5% okay. In the class.
We're a team of three in Ghana.
You are Daniel Gilbert.
When you put three people together watching one football match, you generally have three different opinions.
One of the strikers that stood out was Samuel for me.
What stood out about him?
Had good foundations to his game.
But there's not enough creativity in a key position.
The decision-making process is up to 8 months of recruiting and drawing up short lists of players, which all culminates in one night in a hotel room.
We might ruin a life there if we're not careful with this decision.
It's gut-wrenching when you have to release kids back into the community after a trial, but those kids that we released are just a representation of one generation. And if we feel that we're going to be game changers in Africa, then every year we got to wipe the slate clean and give ourselves the best opportunity of success by finding the next one. There's a lot of inequality in the world, and inequality is not going to change unless we change the next generation. And scouts are closest to changing the next generation, and therefore they need to take the responsible steps to make that difference.
Right to Dream is completely different from any school I've ever been to. The way they teach you, the science equipment, the robotics, it's like a heaven to me. I kept doing what my mother told me, to follow my passion, but I must work hard. But my passions and dreams changed from football to education, to winning a scholarship to school and a university in the US. This journey of me finding new passion is the same as all the other kids here. People who think of Right to Dream to be a football academy, just producing players, are completely wrong. I'm from a generation of Right to Dream, the Tullow generation. At Right to Dream, we are inspired by role models, and my role models are my friends. Shaku, last year's robotics captain, and a top player. He competed nationally and went on finishing 8th in the World Championship, the highest ever for an African team. Now he's on scholarship at Millbrook. Or Husseini, who just won a scholarship to Stanford. Or Ferraz and Adley, who you will hear from very soon. Through the Tullow STEM program, I've learned robotics. I've competed nationally and used it to give back to the wider community. I love this stuff. In 10 years' time, when they play my video to the academy, I want them to show me getting a top degree and back in Takoradi as a Tullow engineer. And I know and I believe I can do it if I keep honoring the advice of my mother. Once again, my name is Enoch Dodu, and I come from Takoradi. I am proud to be a Tullow student, and I want to say thank you. Thank you for all that has passed, and thank you for all that is to come.